My room was dark, like the light was shunned. I had moved into a care center for the first time. I had a roommate, but she never talked to me. The staff didn't acknowledge me. I didn't have a single friend. Worst of all, I couldn't open the drapes in my room. The darkness was worse than the silence. 9 years ago, I could hear myself perfectly. And then one day, nothing. The doctor said it was meningitis. But what I heard was, this is the end of your independence. From that moment on, I withdrew. Visits with friends and trips to the mountains, shopping and watching the Bronco games. It all came to an end. I looked out my kitchen window in silence as the world passed by. After I moved, I talked to my daughter almost every day. Annie was my rock. But I could hear the sadness in her voice on the phone. And then she moved me. I was cautious. But then we pulled up to Cambridge. And I saw bright flowers and sunshine pouring into the front of the lobby. I walked into my room and immediately opened the blinds. An apple tree. Within a few weeks, it began to bloom. Pink and white flowers filled my view. I tried the morning exercise class, then bingo, the movies, fishing, barbecue with my new friends. I'm even the residence council president. I learned how to email, and my staff taught me how to use Facebook. I use it to keep in touch with my family. My nurses and staff care. They are all wonderful, especially Molly. We laugh together and share a story about our families and what it was like growing up. I can't wait for the Bronco games to start for the season. Molly Trolley will watch with me. I may have trouble hearing, but I have no trouble feeling loved. Whereas the nursing home residents of any age or any ability are themselves living history and precious resource. And whereas